Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech. And if you have an iPhone 5S or newer that can have iOS 12.4, there's a new way to transfer information. So maybe you don't have access to iTunes on a computer, or maybe you don't have access to a large iCloud backup. This will allow you to transfer all of your settings and other data from your old phone to your new phone. So I wanted to show you how to do that. You still will need a Wi-Fi connection, but you can also direct transfer from here to here, depending on which device you have. But it will still use Wi-Fi to download all of the apps, and then it will move all of your data into that. Now, first, let's go over what's actually transferred, and then we'll move everything over. So a direct transfer is a new way you can transfer, and it copies information such as your iTunes encrypted backup would. So all of your photos, media, app data, settings, and more are sent over a peer-to-peer wireless connection. Or, like I said, you can wire them, but you will need these two things to do that. You'll need a lightning to USB cable and then your lightning cable. So you'll plug into here and then plug each end into a device, and then you can actually transfer the data. You would only really want to do that if you had a very poor network connection at home. Otherwise, the wireless way is the way to go. Now let's go ahead and set this up. We'll swipe up and you'll see it pops up and says, would you like to set up a new phone? It'll have your Apple ID there and everything. So we'll go ahead and hit continue. Now that this has popped up, what we want to do is just put it in the camera of our phone, and now we'll start the transfer. So it'll say just a moment and it'll set everything up. So now that it's at this point, we need to put in the password or the passcode from our old phone to unlock it, to put it into here, our new phone. So let's go ahead and do that. It'll say setting up your phone. So we'll set this one down here. And it says it may take a few minutes to activate your phone. So again, you will need Wi-Fi to activate it and to transfer your data. Now we'll wait for this a few minutes. And then when this part's done, we'll go to the next step. Now it wants us to set up Face ID. So I'll go ahead and do that. Now you may have Touch ID. So if you have Touch ID, set that up with your thumb or fingerprint. I'll set up Face ID quickly. So Face ID is now set up. I'll hit continue. And this is the new part where it says transfer your data, transfer from iPhone, transfer directly so that this iPhone will be ready with your data when you finish setting up. So let's go ahead and do that. So we'll go ahead and tap on this button here. It'll say setting up your Apple ID still, and your old phone will be unusable for a little while you do this. So keep that in mind, but we'll give it just a moment. Now we have to agree to the terms and conditions, and it says settings from your other phone. We'll just hit continue. So we'll bring everything over automatically, and then Apple Pay. We can set that up later or continue. You'll have to set that up again because that's a security issue. So we'll just hit set up later. And then if you're using an Apple Watch and you want to move it from the old phone to the new one without having to set everything up again, hit continue, or you can set that up later. Now this is app analytics. This allows developers to see when there's crashes and things. It doesn't necessarily let them see your personal data, but it does let them see the crash information. You can decide to share that or not share that. It's up to you. And now it says transferring data from Aaron's iPhone 8 Plus. And you'll see there's the transfer status, and this will take a while. And again, you won't be able to use the phone while it's doing this. So we'll just let this run and hopefully it doesn't take too long. I think it took about 15 minutes before when I tried this, but we'll see. It'll tell us in just a moment. Now it's saying we have about 23 minutes left. This number started at 44 and rapidly decreased to 23. It just depends on your network. And also, if you want to go faster, again, you could use a direct connection like this cable if you really wanted to. So keep that in mind. But we'll wait for this to finish and we'll take a look at what it looks like when it's done. Now that the transfer is complete, it says transfer complete on the old phone. You'll hit continue. And all of your information should match on this phone once it reboots. It starts a reboot as soon as it finishes transferring. So we'll wait for this to reboot. And when it does, we'll see what's over or transferred over. Now the phone has rebooted and you can see the wallpaper now matches. So let's go ahead and unlock it. There we go. Now they match completely. All of the apps are going to install, but all of the app data should also be there as well. So it may take a little bit, but if we go into music, so in music, you'll have all of the same music, but if you have iCloud music, it will just re-download those since it's easier to do that. And we'll hit okay here. And now everything's the same. So all of your photos, everything else should move by itself. And it will move all of the app data into place and you're ready to go. So it may take a while to install all of the different apps and things that you're used to using, but you no longer need to use your iCloud backup that's only maybe 5 gigabytes if you don't pay for extra storage, and maybe you don't have iTunes or a computer to transfer all of this information. So it's really simple, but you will need iOS 12.4 or newer. So that's the catch with that. So all of the exact same settings should be the same. If we go into settings, you'll see it's got my iCloud ID there. If we go to display, even the display settings are the same how I set them for a video. So I turn off True Tone and all of those different things for video, and you'll see even those settings have carried across. So the only thing you'll need to set up new is your Apple Wallet for security reasons, and that's about it. Everything should be the same, and hopefully that helps. Let me know if you have any other questions in the comments below, though, and of course I'll link this wallpaper as I always do. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, and if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.